My name is Jim Bockheim, and I'm a professor of soil science, and I have a courtesy appointment in forest and wildlife ecology and the Institute for Environmental Studies. In the context of permafrost in soils, I study the levels of carbon in soils with the idea that with global warming, that carbon could potentially be released and go into the atmosphere as carbon dioxide. And that also requires that we sample not only the soil, but the permafrost below it. On an average year, I spend somewhere between 4 and 8 weeks in either the Arctic or the Antarctic, or both. The most important thing that I do when I'm on those trips is to describe and sample soils on different landscapes and collect samples that can be brought back to the laboratory for analysis. So we traditionally will describe the different layers. We describe the ice content, the form of the ice, whether it be in veins or lenses. We then will take the cores and we'll cut them up with a chop saw into different layers, and then we will weigh them, put them in cups, put them in the oven, dry them, and when they're dry, we weigh them again, and we can determine the amount of ice, the moisture content, and then we will then take subsamples of that, send them back to our laboratories here in Madison, and then measure organic carbon or different forms of carbon depending on the goal of the particular study. Well, we know right now that as much as 50% of the total soil organic carbon is in soils underlain by permafrost. So clearly, from just a total mass standpoint, soils underlain by permafrost are very important. But the other reason that it's important is that the greatest warming is really occurring in the high latitude areas, whether it be in the high Arctic or along the Antarctic Peninsula. And with that degree of warming, then some of that carbon that's locked up deep in the soil in the upper part of the permafrost can become freed from thawing and could undergo oxidation, microbial changes, and could go back into the atmosphere as carbon dioxide, which would exacerbate the current warming that we're experiencing.